So I have a video uploading right now, but this one's probably going to be a lot shorter, so this one actually might be up before the one that's uploading now. I don't know what this is a video of yet. And Dave here's probably not going to do the honors of telling us either. It's his box.
It's a mystery box.
It's like in that movie set, in that Brad Pitt movie set, and with Brad Pitt and Morgan Freeman, with where he's like, what's in the box? And it turns out to be his wife's severed head. You're a sick, you'd be the sick one to do that.
I mean, maybe. I can either confirm or deny.
Well, come on, what's in the box?
Alright.
I don't feel like going up to the garage and getting a razor blade, so I'm going to use this.
I normally carry knives, but I don't have it on me now.
Oh, you don't?
So I'm feeling it.
It's not very good, Dave.
I know, right?
So it is audio related, I'm assuming.
It hopefully is.
Okay. Just gotta figure out what channel I'm uploading this to. This is the time of year, of course, I'm gonna have more audio content than
air conditioner
sheet content. Other than the garage, I can get up to 90 degrees, no problem anymore. So we literally could just do HVAC work.
Good. But are we?
Nah.
Exactly. See how they package it?
I don't know, the FedEx guy.
And you know what? We don't package our stuff. We just smash everything.
True. You guys are definitely good at that.
Oh.
You want this box, or am I burning this box?
You can burn the box.
I can tell you it's big enough to be a receiver.
It might be.
It's heavy, man. It's heavy enough to be a receiver, too. Is it a quad receiver? It's either a quad receiver or a monster receiver. One of the two.
I wish it was a monster receiver.
So it's a quad receiver.
Maybe not. Maybe it is.
It feels like it is.
It could be a heavy-ass tape player.
What did you get in the Kai? For techniques? Am I still in focus? Yeah, we're in focus.
Well, they have at least two boxes, so they could use better filling in between the two boxes. I think a couple of points from my perspective.
Actually, the package is decent. I've definitely seen worse.
Oh yeah. That 750, that Harman Kardon 750 I got was the package the best. At least not to my opinion. As someone who's a professional package destroyer, they could have done better.
You wanted to withstand you.
Yeah. And that's a very hard thing to do.
Wow, they purple boxed it.
That is another good point.
I still don't see any.
What it could be. This came from Lanshorn or Lansdale? Near Philly.
I'd say it's a freaking receiver. Or
maybe,
if it's a tape deck, it's a very good built one.
It could be.
It's as heavy as that Technique, sir. Which is what we're listening to right now.
Yeah, what was I gonna say? Actually, it's very broken up from the table.
It's one of those things, is I watch it be a brick, and it's just in 20 different boxes. smaller, and eventually it's a big, heavy brick. Kind of like what Sound Design used to do with their equipment. They make it real cheap and throw a big lead weight in there to make it feel heavy. I really wish I went up to the garage and got my razor knife.
Yeah, I'm regretting not carrying it. I got, like, how many safety razors I'm on? Various places. At least 7.
Tell you what, they weren't messing around when they packaged this.
No. They have plenty of cardboard, right? I just have to see a little bubble wrap.
I should have went up to the garage.
Do you want me to grab it?
But I'm so far into it now that now it's a personal mission.
So now if I do bring you the knife, it's going to fail the mission. And we cannot have that. You're working out pretty good for you.
I'm starting to think this is a bunch of boxes. Oh my god, dude! 4 boxes!
The more the better. If you're shipping
anything. Technically, yeah, but sweet shit.
You get like.
Alright, now we're getting somewhere.
Damn it, I want to see that box. What do we have
here? It's upside down.
That's because the package handle was.
It's gotta be a quad receiver. Either that or a pretty beefy, either like I said, a monster stereo receiver or a very beefy, moderate powered receiver.
I can tell you this much, it's not a Pioneer 1010, although I wish it was.
The SX-1010?
Yes, I want one.
Yeah, so do I.
It's beautiful.
It is very beautiful.
Unfortunately, it's not that, but...
It's definitely better. I think it's better looking in the 1980.
I do.
And the 1980 would be a lot better if it didn't have oversized... If all the meters were the same size, it'd be a lot better.
I don't know, I'd be happy with anything Pioneer of that era. Perfectly 100 watts or better, well, at least right now. But I got plenty of stuff that's under 100 watts.
Or at least have some preamp outs.
Or that. And, well, Harman Kardon's got the preamp outs in it.
Yep.
Sansui doesn't, unfortunately. Onkyo I got doesn't. Receivers.
Well, it's definitely not a brick in a bunch of box. Watch it be a box under all this.
I turned to lose it. And I like you get another point for good shipping. For good packaging. You were very unprepared not to build this up.
Yeah, I didn't think it was going to be this over
complicated.
Yeah.
So whatever it is, it's in one piece.
If it's not in one piece, it was definitely grossly mishandled. Okay, I see some wood grain. Ah, oh, it's a Pioneer receiver.
That was good this time. I didn't open up before coming here. Unlike with the Harman Kardon. Because that I had to see.
Oh, that's sexy. Oh, yeah.
Wow. Looking at it, guess what model? Well, you can see the model.
9000.
Yep.
SX-9000. Wow. Oh, this is the one with the...
Up down, yep.
Oh, dude. With a built-in reverberation amplifier.
Yep.
And oh, that tuning knob feels so good. Dude, the needle's behind it. Oh, that's so cool. And what's the watts per channel on this?
50.
50?
50 in the 8 ohms. And this goes down to 4 ohms. Which is good. Because I didn't want something that would do 4 ohms.
Any receiver will drive a 4 ohm load if you only have one set of speakers.
Well, I guess it's a Pioneer receiver. Gotta hook up some Pioneer speakers to it.
I think we have a set in there.
Yeah. I think I'm gonna go grab that set quick.
Yeah, do it.
I'm gonna bump the tripod again.
Well, you can go 3 sets of speakers up to this.
As the
I wonder if this is one of the ones you're going to need a special speaker adapter for.
Yes.
Do you have them?
No. So we're just going to stickalize that speaker wire in there.
All right.
And hope for the best. So that's one thing I got. Another good song.
Bass, flat, soft. Vivid. Volume. Wow, master volume. You can adjust your source too.
It's a very well featured.
2 auxiliaries, that's nice.
Should have at least one phono. Maybe
2 turntables.
Okay.
2 tape inputs.
Oh, hell yeah.
Speakers A, B, C, and
those have C. Okay.
And mute.
Nice.
Oh, that kicks them all off. Look at that, that's cool. Dude, that's awesome looking. Now, what did this run you?
$299?
And it works.
In the video the guy showed it did. Because he actually has a video on the ad. So.
Okay.
Let me get the other speaker out.
All right. Well. It's a 10 minute one for now. Yeah, let's hook it up. We'll do this. We'll do it in the same video. Why not?
Okay.
These Pioneers are freaking massive, man. Oh, sorry, Dave. There you go. I have to readjust.
You have to reset the camera. Yeah.
That's all right. I was supposed to get a little bit, but I think anything and everything is in the way right now because we're kind of
tripping on each other.
Yeah.
We're getting a little close for comfort.
Yeah, how about it?
I guess I should
order this. We're not going to go crazy. But we are going to hook it up. One HPM 100.
At least I'm not going to be a stool this time.
Two HPM 100.
Heavy little buggers. Some pre-cut links.
I thought we did. Yeah. I could have sworn we had some cut. Yep, here it is.
Yeah, what's the gig? Oh, dude, they make the ones with banana plugs on them. Yeah.
Okay, good.
I get those, yeah.
Yeah. Washer.
That's a washer. I say, tell me, what the hell's going on with this dog?
Ow.
Careful.
Party time. This is our kind of cheap basement we have happening.
CD player. Oh, this is gonna be a pain in the ass.
I hook these up in speaker A. I don't know what one's positive, what one's negative. Well, I'll go with electric. Electric, the smaller prong is always positive, and your bigger one's negative. So we'll go with the go with that.
If not, we'll reverse the letters.
You're not gonna know.
Or that, yeah.
Yeah, you're not gonna know. You'll probably look it up online, but we're just doing a test anyway.
Ain't no one got time for that.
You know I got time for that.
Yeah.
Dude, the first time I saw that fucking commercial, that was hilarious.
I don't think I've probably seen the commercial, but I forget it. So I use another saying.
It's almost as iconic as a Cheryl with her she shed one. That was freaking funny too.
I guess those would be the next that, or I'm just gonna have Zach do the upgrade and just put banana plug straight on and get rid of that.
You could do that, but honestly, it's going to be kind of tight. Yeah, it is a little tight, and there's a big heat sink right behind it. Alright. Oh, that has the old brown style cord on it. It says Pioneer right on it. It's off, right?
Yes.
Speakers are off?
Okay.
Yep. So let's take predictions here. I bet it's going to be a nice, warm, refined sound.
It's from according to Hi-Fi Engine. This is from 1970.
Okay.
Which is kind of
so high. So that was just when the real high fidelity stuff was just taking off.
Yep.
I mean, not that '60s equipment was bad, but
no. Some of those two stuff in the '60s was amazing.
Yeah, hi-fi was really starting to become real mainstream at that point in time. Oh, the CD player isn't here.
I know what Dave's gonna pick. Mozzie Star, Fade Into You.
You know it. Every time.
That's a good choice.
It was a good choice.
Absolutely. That's probably a dumb place to put the CD player. Yeah, it's definitely a dumb place. It's only for a short period of time.
It'll be fine.
I just feel bad about putting on top of the Pioneer because, like,
it looks so good.
It does.
And then you put that.
And
on
this
top,
CD player does not look that good. I have all my good ones hooked up right now, so this is all we got at the moment. Shit. It's freaking hot in here anyway.
I'm gonna say I might kill some heaters.
Yeah, may as well, dude. I'm good with it.
Save on the electrons a little bit. I like is this tone colorer on it.
Alright, we're gonna put this.
Shinkalize it back a little bit.
Yeah, I'll hide it. I'll put it on top of this speaker here that we're not using right now. I'll use this as a weight to hold it in place. Yeah, I'm good with that. And then all the CDs are right here too, so. I need a RCA cable.
Yep.
How much? Tons of those laying around.
Should be plenty of them. I will just steal it from somewhere.
I ordered some more of them today.
Good deal.
Yeah, I used my last one last night. Let me see if I have one.
Back here?
There might be one back here.
Not. Should be.
Not very long, so we're probably coming back over here with it, but that's okay. We're gonna put this into auxiliary one. This thing is gorgeous, though.
It is.
Yeah, we'll put the CV player face in the back. That way I'll still get the same. There you go. Perfect. But I really hate to have it blocked. The Pioneer that is.
Yeah.
We're still recording, right?
Yep. And also we have auxiliary 2 right here, so we'll cheat a little bit.
I cheated in my earlier video today, too. That'll be auxiliary too.
I love the aux cord.
You get everybody Kenny that likes a Bluetooth adapter.
Yep.
That's kind of insulting to use a Bluetooth, something
like this.
Mm-hmm. At least this is still a straight freaking signal. I'm not knocking digital, I'm knocking wireless. There's a difference.
Yeah.
CDs are technically a digital format, so we'll do some killers. Start with Dave. I already knew what Dave's request was going to be.
This song's going to add on to. Well, we got the aux.
This song does sound so freaking good, though. Here's a Wheeler Walker Jr.
Can do some of that.
I see there's two of them.
Yeah, one for source, one is master.
So I'll probably set the source about halfway. It doesn't have a marking on there for it.
It does, it's just hard to see.
It does it?
Yeah, it's on your fingers over it.
Oh, really?
That's all we can.
There you go.
That's a pain in the ass.
Oh, okay. We'll keep it at halfway. Whoa. I really wish that washer wasn't on. Everything's flat, right?
Yep, bass and treble's flat.
So far, it sounds good. Yeah, we're both on speakers A. Where's your balance at? A dirty contact. Stereo, okay. Left plus mono, left plus right, everyone stereo.
Yeah,
we'll have to take this and zoom in on that. Gonna work.
Too tall.
They sound freaking great though.
So for my little home air quotes set for my room, it's on top of a dresser cabinet thing. I got 21 inches to play with. These are definitely too tall.
You were thinking about hooking this up in your house.
Mm-hmm. But I'm getting some decent-ish, hopefully quality El Chico speakers soon. So yeah, because right now I got the MCS series thing, combination unit, but eventually you guys will see a video of that when I bring it over.
Alright.
And those speakers when they come in. But this might replace the MCS thing.
I'd hope so. Put it back in the rack. They saw the fancy features.
The screen door slams. Mary dress waves.
It has a
sort like of a vision. She dances across the porch as the radio.
Should I keep that right in the middle? There it is. The one that's the middle one.
Hey, that's me, and I want you only. Don't Don't turn me home again. I just can't face myself alone again. Don't run back inside, darling. You know just what I'm here for. So you're scared and you're thinking that maybe we ain't that young anymore. Show a little faith, there's magic in the night. You ain't a beauty, but hey, you're alright. Oh, and it's alright with me.
I love it.
You can hide your colors and study your pain, because the lover's stories of the rain. Waste your summer praying in vain for a savior to rise from these streets. But I know you're all that's understood.
For one of the best few seconds in rock and roll right here.
I'm not afraid.
Pioneer receivers.
Yeah.
And this was on there. I'm like, huh. I wonder how expensive that is. That looks pretty neat. And I started looking around.
You gotta keep in mind, dude, that in 1970, 50 watts per channel was ridiculous.
A lot.
Joe, I would definitely, like I said, you want to give this to Zach someday and have him I'm sure he can fix that problem. That's probably a noisy capacitor or a transistor or something on the lines of that. Get one good view of it before we end the video here. Look at that's gonna be a thumbnail photo. That is beautiful, dude.
So I saw that they existed. I was doing some more research on them. I was like, huh. See how pricey they are.
I did not know about this receiver.
And they weren't stupidly expensive. So I'm like, yeah, find one for a decent deal and pick one up.
They won't be. People want the freaking the X80 series.
And the SX50s.
And the X50 series.
God, they're expensive.
They are. Honestly, dude, they say the 50s are built better, but I pick the 80s every time because of the VU meters. That's gorgeous. All right, folks, there you have it. The Pioneer SX9000. Badass.
Peace. We're actually going to go through that schmeal again because I actually realized that we didn't even look at the back of the receiver. And it's got some pretty neat stuff on the back, too.
So, yeah, we were talking about the freaking tuner, the... tuner here. Dave doesn't listen to FM as much as I do, but he said he would like it to work. That's a good station too. They always playing something freaking good or something that we never heard before. So we're gonna take a look at the back quick. It would be better if it worked properly. So this is Ghetto Fabulous. We're gonna take that out of here because we're done playing with it, at least for now. So this is a pretty neat feature. It actually does have pre-outs on it, but it's not like your usual with the jumpers. This one here actually has a switch on the back. I've never seen that before. Well, I'm sure it's not the only model like that. That's your ground for the turntables. I'm shocked they don't have it over here, but whatever. Don't matter. It works the same way. Center channel out. Interesting. I wonder if there wasn't like some kind of weird, pre-quadraphonic thing they had what?
It's either that. I'd say a sub, but subs weren't really I'm sure they existed, but they weren't super popular back then.
It's your antenna connector, your data plate.
Yeah.
It's very well featured.
It is.
Very well featured.
Especially for having, back in the day, having three speaker inputs and preamp out jumpers and two auxiliaries. Think about it. Go back to 1970. So you have put yourself in that situation. Obviously, wait, where's your tape? Where's your other tape input? There's tape A. Where's tape B? Oh, right here. Okay, so this one has to use it. Okay, so that one you need to defend, which they are. Don't worry, they are available. You can get them. They're rare, but you can get them. So there it is. They just don't have the RCAs. So you have, there's your A track, and there's your cassette or reel, whatever you wanted. You have two auxiliaries. You can't hook a phonograph up through an auxiliary. So even if you wanted to have a reel-to-reel recorder and a cassette recorder to have the A-track through one of the auxiliaries, you still have an extra auxiliary. So unless you're planning for the future, which maybe they were planning for the future, but at that point in time, what the hell else are you actually going to hook up to that?
Yeah, you had reel-to-reel, A-tracks,
and cassettes at the time for cassette, tape.
Yeah.
That were mainstream formats. You had other like goofy ones out there, like the 4-track, but no one really, that was irrelevant at that point in time. Yeah, like I said, unless you want to hook another tape player up, I mean, you could do that, but really, CDs didn't exist for another 12 years yet. They wouldn't be mainstream for another 15. So, yeah, I don't know. That's pretty cool. So this thing was definitely a little bit ahead of its time. It's had three speaker outputs. You got to be careful, though, with that. I'm actually shocked it lets you turn all three on at the same time. Yeah, there's your two monitors. You can use one of the monitors for an equalizer too, but with all honesty, with this receiver, you don't need an equalizer. It has a tone coloration, it has a very, very sensitive tone control on it. You can add some, add reverb to it. The loudness button kicks ass. I love that. I don't care what any of the quote unquote audio elitists say. The loudness button is awesome. You shouldn't have a loudness button. Like, fuck you. Who the hell are you to tell me what I should have my equipment set to and what I shouldn't? Eat a dick. That's pretty cool. This, you can turn, like, them on and off.
I mean, karaoke night times two. Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah. Yes, obviously your Sansui Quad Set will be your main system, but this here, honestly, dude, is great.
The best garage system ever.
I wouldn't put this in the garage, dude. I mean, you could. But
you
wouldn't
put anything on the garage.
I'd use this in, like, if you have like a family room or something like that, or another place you can jam out, or if you have a bar room like this to hang. Like, this would be I would hook this up down here. Okay, this would easily fill this whole entire room up with sound, easily. Like something like that, where you want this in a place where people are going to listen to it. This should honestly be your secondary system. With those pine, like I said, and honestly, when we had that hooked up to the Marantz, what else did we hook it up to? We hooked these up to a few receivers.
The Onkyo TX850 and my Harman Kardon 730.
Yeah, these didn't sound as good. We hooked up to either one of those.
The Onkyo was pretty good.
Was it?
Oh, yeah. Well, the Onkyo is 68 watts per channel.
Okay.
And it's got a whole bunch of fancy, this is an 88 receiver.
You hooked Kenny's JBLs up to it too, right?
Yes.
And you're on par. These Pioneers matched up the best with this. Hands down.
I have the AB right now, but yeah.
Dude, they sound really, that sounds great. Like, there's no reason to even, it's the only thing we need to do is we need to get you a ring for that. And a HPM 100 logo, which are available on eBay.
Complete.
And obviously you get a Pioneer cassette deck and a Pioneer turntable to go with it, just because. Might as well
keep the Pioneer stack happening over here.
You can get a Pioneer CD player and put a wood case on it. You could easily do that. And I think there's a couple silver face models you can get.
Okay.
And like I said, half of it's black too, so you can there's all kinds of stuff you can do to customize it, make it more, you know. Yeah.
Well, that's what I like a lot about the looks of the earlier Pioneers, is they had the contrast with the black and the silver.
So basically, anything goes with it. Honestly, an A-Track player would look really good with that, even though it's not Pioneer. Or the early Akai's would look good with that, especially the CR80. I wouldn't go with the 80DSS, because it's a four-channel deck, and this is a two-channel receiver. But if you got the CR80, has a black on top, it's silver on top, black on the bottom. So it'd be like reverse. It would look sick next to it. But yeah, I mean, this is a great match right here. And definitely get the banana plug
adapters
for the back.
I love this freaking door. Kind of reminds me of the Bose 551. I love it. Well, yeah, that's it this time. I mean it. Yeah.
Peace out. Thanks for watching. I will catch you guys next time. Wah.